Hi, my name is Craig, and in this session, I'm going to talk about building or adapting Xamarin and Xamarin Forms apps for dual-screen devices like the Microsoft Surface Duo. I'll start by quickly introducing the Surface Duo, then talk about how your app's user experience can be adapted for dual-screen devices. We'll then look at the Xamarin Forms features available for targeting the Surface Duo, and how the dual-screen enhancements you make can adapt to other devices and platforms as well. Finally, we'll take a quick look at the upcoming .NET multi-platform application UI and how it will support dual-screen devices in future. This is a Microsoft Surface Duo. The first thing you'll notice is that it has two screens and a 360-degree hinge, so that you can use it in a number of different postures, from single screen, like your current phone, or you can open it up for double the display area. When using two screens, you can multitask with two apps side by side, or you can span an app across both. Secondly, it's an Android device. You can get apps and games from Google Play, and it comes pre-installed with all the Microsoft apps you'd expect, including Office, Outlook, Teams, and more. Finally, like the rest of the Surface Duo range, it also works great with pen input. All existing Android apps run on the Surface Duo. It behaves like any other device when apps run a single screen. When apps are spanned across both screens, developers can detect this and enhance their user experience for the extra display area. Because it's Android, if you're a C# and .NET developer, the easiest way to build apps for the Surface Duo is using Xamarin Android or Xamarin Forms. NuGet packages are available to help detect device capabilities and adapt layouts for two screens. When thinking about how to adapt your Xamarin applications, first identify what's at the core of your current user interface, and plan how that will scale to a larger display area. It's a similar process to enhancing a phone app for tablet and desktop. To help developers, we've documented 5 core user experience design patterns that work well on dual screen devices. The first is extended canvas, which means a single layout taking up the entire area, such as a map, a drawing surface, or a spreadsheet. List detail is the common hierarchical navigation pattern used in everything from to-do apps to email readers. Two-page is an embodiment of the book metaphor, used for reading apps or any other views where you want to paginate horizontally. Dual view is about using the two screens for different views of the same data, like a map and a list, or an editor and a preview. And lastly, companion pane means using the second screen for a command palette or for game controls. We have a Figma resource available to help your designers mock up dual screen layouts and code examples that show how to implement each of these in C# and XAML. To show what I mean, I'm going to explain how to refactor a list detail app and enhance it for dual screens. The steps I'm going to describe next are part of our Microsoft Learn module on building dual screen Xamarin Forms apps. The module is available at aka.ms/learn-xamarin-dual-screen. And includes links to the open source project on GitHub. The training describes how to update an existing list detail app for the Surface Duo using dual screen features in Xamarin Forms. The two key dual screen features of Xamarin Forms are dual screen info and TwoPaneView. Dual screen info is a non-visual helper class that provides access to device information such as whether your app is spanned across two screens, and if so, the coordinates of the display area and the hinge. You can use this class to manipulate your layouts directly to position controls around the area between the screens. TwoPaneView is a layout control that can automatically adjust for two screens, so it's easy to place controls and let it do all the work. It's highly configurable for different layouts on all screen sizes. The Microsoft Learn course I mentioned covers both of these, but today I'm going to focus on TwoPaneView. So let's check out the app. The sample app, Fun with Flags, uses the common list detail pattern, which starts with a scrolling list of options and selecting an item opens up in the details. Both the list and the details use the entire screen, so you have to switch back and forth between them. It's a little hard to see, but the detail view also includes arrows in the nav bar to help navigate up and down without returning to the list. This pattern is used in email and contacts apps, note-taking and to-do apps, and even messaging-style apps might have a list of rooms or channels before you enter. Xamarin Forms navigation is used to show the detail page and to provide the back button behavior. To get these two views side by side, the list of flags and the flag image and description on the Surface Duo will require some code changes. Let's imagine what we need to do to make this page structure work on a dual screen device. The current structure in Xamarin Forms uses two content pages, one containing the list and the second containing the details. Xamarin Forms navigation helps you switch between them by selecting an item and pressing the button, back button. The two pages go into the navigation stack. They are not designed to be viewed side by side. Because we want to preserve the existing behavior on a single screen device, but show these together on the Surface Duo, we'll need to do some refactoring by extracting the details XAML into a reusable content view. This will enable us to embed the details in a page on the navigation stack, as well as host in a two-pane view on the Surface Duo. This is the original XAML for the list page, which is also the root page for the app. It contains a list view with data binding and a tapped event that will open the detail page. I've hidden the item template for clarity. We want to be able to show the list and the details side by side. So in theory, I want to add the flag and image description to this XAML, but it's currently in another content page. This snippet is from the content page and shows the stack layout that contains the flag image and text. Notice how it also defines the toolbar items for navigating between details, which are only useful on single screen devices. Content pages can't be nested inside each other, so to get the list and details side by side, I need to refactor the image view, picker, and other controls into a content view instead of a content page. I'm going to take everything inside the stack layout and move it to a new file. Here's the XAML after refactoring. It's in a new file called FlagView. Very few changes were required other than the root element being a content view and moving over the relevant C# code behind as well. We can now reuse this content view back in the details page where it was extracted from, as well as on a dual screen side-by-side layout. Here's the details XAML from two slides ago, but now instead of a stack layout full of controls, it uses the reusable content view we just created. Note that a new XML namespace is declared at the top, so we can reference the shared view. Then towards the bottom, you can see the flag view element, which contains all of the refactored XAML. The up and down toolbar items are still present and will continue to work on single screen devices. Now let's return to the app's root view, which was previously just a list. We've made quite a few changes here. Firstly, there are two additional namespaces added to the content page element. XMLNS dual screen, which brings in the dual screen controls, and XMLNS views, which provides access to the shared content view. The page then contains a new two-pane view control, which includes the list view inside pane 1. This is going to be displayed on all devices. It's still the root view of the app. You might have noticed I skipped the length attributes defined on the two-pane view. We'll come back to those later. Pane 2 contains the refactored details flag view. This pane will only show on larger screens. On a phone, it'll be hidden, and the flag details will be pushed onto the navigation stack, just like the original design. In the code behind, which I'm not going to show, the tapped event needs to work differently to support that. It will use the navigation stack when required on single screens, but when pane 2 is visible, data binding will update the details automatically. After extracting the details screen to make it reusable and embedding the list in a two-pane view, the app supports existing user experience on phone-sized devices, and when the app is spanned across both screens on a Surface Duo, both views are displayed and aligned to the hinge. Now we've seen how the two-pane view helped take our layout from the phone form factor to the dual-screen Surface Duo. What about other Android devices? An important aspect of the dual-screen controls is that they still work on other devices where Xamarin Forms runs and provide customization options on those devices. Here's the two-pane view XAML again, and I've highlighted the row that sets the optional pane length attributes. On the Surface Duo, these are ignored, since the panes are aligned to the hinge. However, on larger devices, and you can configure the screen size when this kicks in, the layout is going to use 1/3 of the screen for the list and the rest for the details. Here's the app running on a variety of Android devices. On regular phones, the behavior is the same as before, with two content pages being pushed and popped using navigation. On the Surface Duo and larger screens, the two-pane view and data binding provide the layout and item selection side by side. On the tablet, the proportional length properties are used to control the layout widths. So redesigning the user experience helps with both dual screen and larger screen devices. So with a little planning and code refactoring, we got an enhanced experience for a huge chunk of our users. But Xamarin Forms is a cross-platform framework too. So what about Apple devices? And here's the same app running on iPhone and iPad. The two-pane view control provides a solid foundation for both dual screen and all larger screen sizes across multiple platforms. The proportional configuration will work just as well, targeting Xamarin Forms supported desktop platforms like Windows and macOS. There's one last dual screen aspect I'd like to cover, and that is other foldable devices in the Android ecosystem. Xamarin Forms and its dual screen controls will also run on those devices. You can use the different properties of dual screen info and two-pane view to control the way your app looks on other foldables, as well as Surface Duo. There's also a new Jetpack Window Manager library available in Android, and we've provided a Xamarin binding on NuGet, which will help access foldable features across all device types. The Window Manager is currently in pre-release, but we'll be sharing more about it once it's stable. Development for those other foldable devices is just as easily done with Xamarin and Visual Studio as it is with the Surface Duo. Here's a quick example of the Flag app running on the 6.7-inch and 8-inch foldable emulators, which correspond to popular foldable Android devices that are currently available. You can see that on the narrower screens, the app behaves like a regular phone, and the wider screen, the proportional layout kicks in. Two-pane view has a number of customizable properties to help you tweak this behavior, or you can do more sophisticated capabilities detection and layout changes using Window Manager. No matter what range of screen sizes, foldables, and platforms you plan to support, Xamarin Forms and the dual screen controls it provides can help you do it in a responsive and reusable way. Before I finish, I also wanted to share our plans for dual screen support in the .NET Multi-Platform App UI, or .NET MAUI, which is due towards the end of this year along with .NET 6. Here's a screenshot of my first .NET MAUI app running a preview version on the Xamarin on the Surface Duo. .NET MAUI is the next iteration of Xamarin Forms and will include a migration path for existing Xamarin Forms apps. When it comes to dual screen support, .NET MAUI will use the same controls we discussed earlier, dual screen info and two-pane view. They'll just be in a different namespace. Updating your dual screen apps should be as simple as changing the namespace in your code in XAML. So don't wait. Start building dual screen experiences today and update to .NET MAUI when it's released. That's it for the session. Just a reminder that everything I discussed today, except for that last bit about .NET MAUI, is also covered in our Microsoft Learn module on building dual screen Xamarin Forms apps. I hope you check it out. Thanks for joining me for this quick overview of dual screen Xamarin Form app development. For more information, check out the documentation and our blog, follow us on Twitter, and visit GitHub for open source code examples. Check out aka.ms/MAUI for more info on the future of Xamarin Forms. Enjoy the rest of Microsoft Build 2021.